Hey beautifuls, I am doing a video tutorial on this simple Valentine's Day slash date night makeup look. Love the red lip and I wanted to share it with you all today. It's that time of the year, so want to find something that's simple. Now, pay no attention to my face because I've been breaking out. Pregnancy has been kicking my behind and it's showing all over my forehead. But today, I am going to go ahead and do this simple makeup look for you. We're going to start off, first of all, with a clean, fresh face. And I am going to make sure that we apply our E.L.F. Illuminating Face Primer, which is for fine lines and a luminous finish. This is a awesome product to get because I really feel like it makes my makeup last a very long time. And for a 0.47 fluid ounce bottle, you're really getting a lot of bang for your buck. So we're gonna go ahead and rub that into my face to make sure that all that makeup sticks to my face. Oh my God. Let me just tell you that pregnancy stress is making it almost impossible not to break out. So because of that, those breakouts, I start off with this NYX Conceal, Correct, and Contour Palette in Deep. It's a cruelty-free product, and I am using it for the color corrector right here to kind of buff out those dark marks from those recent breakouts. Now, this has been like a savior for me because you see all those Instagram pictures, my skin is not that perfect. So let's just keep it 100. That color corrector will save your life when it comes to getting rid of those dark marks. You do have to use it sparingly. I would not put this entire thing on your face, on your whole face. I would just use it for those problem areas that you're worried about peeking out under your foundation and your concealer. And this particular shade of orange is perfect for me because it's not too bright or too dark that you can see it under my makeup. So that is in Deep, the NYX Conceal Correct Contour Palette. The color that I have is in Deep. And I just buff it out with my fingers. I'm not gonna waste a brush on this. And I just rub it in just to make sure that it blends in right under my foundation and my concealer. Okay, next up is the CoverGirl Outlast Stay Fabulous 3-in-1 Foundation. I use the color Soft Sable. It's a foundation, a primer, and a concealer in one. This is my absolute favorite, must have. Probably the only foundation that I use outside of some other CoverGirl foundations, but this is really my go-to. And it really helps blend into my skin very well. And like I said, with all that NYX Conceal Corrector Contour Palette, you can't really see it under air. And I am using the Real Techniques Complexion Sponge in High Definition for great results. This is the E.L.F. Eyebrow Kit in 81303 Dark. I started off with the Tarte, the Brow Architect, and Deep to kind of like brush out my eyebrows. And then I went behind with the E.L.F. Eyebrow Kit. This eyebrow kit, although was very inexpensive, it has really given me more than my money's worth. I have been using this eyebrow kit for quite some time, and I'm not even done yet. It really lasts a very long time, and I love the results. Now, when it comes to my eyebrows, I try to keep it as simple as possible because I really don't particularly like cartoon type of eyebrows on me, like too structured. So I'm just really just filling in my natural brow shape just to give it like a little bit more darker hue because of all the makeup. And then I follow that behind with the E.L.F. Cream Eyeliner in Black. And let me tell you, I found the E.L.F. Angle Eyeliner Brush and thought this was amazing. It's really helping me with my wings and my line, because I'm not perfect. My hands shake, I got long nails, it's a lot. So finding that angle eyeliner brush has helped me like really produce better lines on my eyelashes. Alright, so now I'm using the LA Girl Pro Conceal HD Concealer in Cool Tan to start that highlight and contour. Now, my highlight contour process is very vigorous. I'm like, I'm off the chain. So, I mean, if this is not your particular thing, you don't want to do all that, then you can just go ahead and bypass all that. I have gotten almost addicted to it, and now I can't help but do it all the time. So going in with my Evian Natural Mineral Water Brumeister Tour Facial Spray. Yes, that's a mouthful. I go ahead and spray my Real Techniques Complexion Sponge and dampen it with the spray. Now this mineral water spray is water, and it's really great for toning your face, refreshing your face, and applying your makeup. And I've been using it for almost a year now, and it's been amazing. The results are amazing, and it really helps get that makeup applied perfectly. Now, I go back through with the LA Girl Pro Conceal HD Concealer in Dark Cocoa to kind of finish off the highlight and contour process. It is extensive, but I love it. I don't know why. I do. And for those of you who don't like makeup, I can understand, like, you're like really irritated by all of that. And looking at it, I can see that. But I really like the results after this versus me just doing what I was doing prior to 2009. Back to that Evian Brumeister Tour. I hope I'm saying that right. Brumeister Tour Facial Spray. It really helps buff in the concealer with the beauty sponge and dampen it better than just plain water. And then also in future videos, you'll see me using that spray for my eyeshadow as well, because it really helps the color pop. Now, for those of you looking for a different option, you can also use the NYX Conceal Correcting Contour Palette to go back and do your highlight and contour as well. So I'm going to show you another way of doing it. I use the yellow under my eyes to go over it like I did with the LA Girl Pro Concealer. And, you know, if you're not really into using the LA Girl product, I was just suggesting that the NYX Conceal Correcting Contour Palette is another option. And this creamy palette, it really blends in really great. You don't need a whole lot, which I had to learn several times because I can be a little heavy-handed. So you don't need a whole lot, and it does a great job. And the colors really pop as far as bringing out your highlight and your contour. I am not a professional, so I don't know if I'm like overdoing it by putting so much on, but I really like the end results when I really apply it. So I wanted to show you how you can also use the brown for the contour portion going through your face. I feel like I'm about to go do surgery or something. What is all this cutting up of my face? Buff it out. Buff it out. And that Real Techniques complexion sponge is nothing but the truth. All right, so next I'm using the NYX HD Finishing Powder. It's a mineral-based HD Finishing Powder in banana. I go under my eyes with it so that I can bake. Now, the process of baking is just so that you won't look oily and shiny in those particular areas. And I use it under my eyes, down the bridge of my nose, and on my forehead. I let that sit for 10 minutes. And while I'm doing that, I'm using the NYX Correction Contour Palette. And I mixed it with some E.L.F. High Definition Powder to create this brown powderish consistency so I can really do that contour under my cheekbones like I want. Because I feel like both the NYX Pro Concealer and the contour palette is just a little bit too creamy for me to get the type of matte contour that I like on my cheekbones. Under it, I use the LA Girl Pro Concealer in Cool Tan to lighten under the cheekbones. And I blend that out with my Real Techniques beauty sponge. Next up, I use my Telescopic Shocking Extensions Mascara from L'Oreal. I love this mascara. I just use it for the bottom lids because on the top I have Eye Envy by Kiss individual lashes that I done myself. They're not free, medium, and black. I buff out that high definition powder using my e.l.f. powder brush. And that's after it's been on for 10 minutes. And you can kind of see like the oils and stuff being kind of like, I don't know, absorbed through the powder, so you're not really just putting white powder all over your face. You're really buffing it out. So now I'm using my CoverGirl Queen Collection Lasting Matte Pressed Powder in medium deep. This is the key to that matte face. Like when you see me up front, close and personal, people wonder like, how does her makeup stay so matte? Because I do this. I go over all of that with this matte pressed powder. And CoverGirl Queen Collection is another go-to of mine. CoverGirl is my stuff. I love it. Between CoverGirl and e.l.f., I just can't get enough of it. All right, so I'm going to use this e.l.f. Blush Palette. I use the lighter brownish color that it won't show so much. Since I'm wearing a bold red lip, I really don't think I need a lot of blush. And this palette comes in light. I have it in light. Just a little on the cheekbones, you know, not too much. Next up is my Nika K lip liner in brown deep. Now, I line my lips before I put lipstick on. It just helps my lipstick last longer and stay on. So, using brown lipstick under a hot red color just gives me what I need. Lining them also helps me because I don't know how to put lipstick on without going outside the lines. All right, so this is the Wet n Wild Matte Lipstick in Red Velvet. Wet n Wild, like $2.99. Go to Walgreens, CVS, Dollar General even. Wet n Wild lipsticks are awesome. They have very vibrant colors. They last a very long time. And it's cost effective, budget friendly. It's beautiful. Keeping up with those little bottles, though, can be annoying. And if you haven't really gotten into the liquid lipstick trend, you'll appreciate this product. I like it. And to finish everything off, I am going with my e.l.f. Makeup Mist and Set with Aloe, Green Tea, Cucumber, Vitamin A, C, and E. It's in clear. Woo! Yes. That's a cold blast of beautifulness for your behind, but I love the end result. Now, I say this look is simple, but some of you may not believe so. It's simple for me. Only takes about 30 to 45 minutes to do. And I think with this beautiful look, you can go all night long without worrying about messing up your makeup. And for all of you out there who are planning on making out with your boo, you don't have to worry so much about making sure that you wash your face off at the end of the night, even though you should, because once you wake up, you won't look like crap. I would just take the red lip off though. But other than that, this is a sexy, beautiful look for Valentine's Day. I really hope you like it, because I sure do, and hubby does too. So make sure you check me out at GaptoothDiva.com. If you like this video, please subscribe and follow me on Instagram, YouTube, Twitter, and everywhere else. Facebook at GaptoothDiva, GAPTOOTHDIVA.